Welcome back with a short stream. I got a new game today. It's called Clad in Iron, Sakhalin 1904. And this is the, one of the successors to other Ironclad games that I've previously showcased. I just got it today and I wanted to start a campaign. Any, doesn't matter. I just wanted to get into it and play it for a bit, see what's new. Because I think there are a ton of new features, probably some of the older quirks have been worked out. And that should be nice to see. I don't have sound yet, but maybe that will come in a bit. I'll keep an eye on that. So, the... Russo-Japanese War of 1904-1905 was a war for the basically the naval supremacy in the Sea of Okhotsk and the Sea of Japan between Japan and Russia in the sea around the Kuril Islands. And Sakhalin, which is this this large island just east of the Russian coast. Vladivostok is down here, and the Japanese islands are this way, further to the south. These are called the Kuril Islands. This is Sakhalin, as I said. And this over here, this peninsula, is a very large peninsula. It's called Kamchatka. Let me read this flavor text. In the 19th century, Russia and Japan began to develop wild but rich in natural resources on the shores of the Sea of Okhotsk. By 1875, the island of Hokkaido and the Kuril Islands, that's this island chain here, were under Japanese rule, and Sakhalin Island, it's this one over here, and the Kamchatka Peninsula up here, were part of the Russian Empire. In early 1904, Japan and Russia launched a war for domination in the Far East. The main events in this war took place in Manchuria, that's the landmass over here, east and north of Vladivostok. And around the Russian naval base in China, which is called the city of Port Arthur. I believe today it's called Dalian, if I'm not mistaken. But even in the Sea of Okhotsk, the opponents were ready to fight. I believe the Sea of Okhotsk, I think that's this ocean here, between Kamchatka, Sakhalin, and the Russian mainland, and the Kuril Islands, I believe that's this ocean. The opponents were ready to fight. Will Russia be able to protect Sakhalin Island from the Japanese invasion? Will Japan lose the Kuril Islands? It depends only on you. Let's go. The conflict is the Russo-Japanese War of 1904-1905. And in game, it is represented with the period of March 1904 to September 1904, 28 turns. Location is the Sea of Okhotsk, Sea of Japan. We have the Empire of Japan versus the Russian Empire. The task is to control on the final turn Korsakovsky, Alexandrovsk, Petropavlovsk, Rakoshima, Kataoka, and Abashiri. Let's see, Abashiri is this port here. Rakoshima is one of the ports in the Kuril Islands, and Kataoka is a port in the very north of the Kuril Islands. Basically, it's for these three ports. Historically, Russia pretty much lost this war in a decisive naval battle, which happened just before this. No, actually, it happened during during this period, but I believe this battle, which was actually quite large in terms of how many ships participated. I don't think that this battle is featured in the game. I think the game tries to model the lesser important aspects of the war, smaller naval engagements and so on. All right, let's get started. We are playing as the Russians. I still hear no sound. That's because the music volume is low. I'm going to keep it low. So you can hear me well. I see that I haven't switched on the... image capture. Let's take care of that quickly. I can find the correct window. I think now I have it. Let's see if I can get the image. Yes, we can. Okay. Let's try this again. Let's take the Russian campaign. Okay, so let's recap very quickly. First, flavor text. In the 19th century, Russia and Japan had a were developing the Far East region, the Kuril Islands, the Kamchatka Peninsula. In the northwest, the Sakhalin Island, just off the coast of the Russian Far East, which is this landmass over here. The Kuril Islands, Sea of Okhotsk, Sea of Japan, Vladivostok is here. And Japan and Russia basically battled it out for domination in this area. And in real history, Russia experienced a decisive defeat in the Battle of Tsushima. They had pretty much 2/3 of their surface fleet, or of their fleet, wiped out. They lost, I think, 5 out of 6 battleships and several other ships, and had to make huge concessions to Japan. But this decisive battle isn't featured in the game here because it was quite large in terms of how many ships participated. So the game focuses on smaller naval engagements around, as a part of this war. And for the game, the goal is for us to control, Orzhokovsky, that's the southern port on Sakhalin. Alexandrovsk, which is I believe in the north or in the center of Sakhalin, and Petropavlovsk, which is a port on Sakhalin, as well as the Japanese ports at the beginning of the game. They are Japanese: Abashiri, Rakoshima, and Kataoka along the Kuril Islands chain. Okay, let's get started. First, let's get an overview over our forces. So our ports are the ones in gold, and the Japanese ones are in light gray, dark blue. So we have a commerce raider, 12,000 ton. We have actually three of them, 12,000 tons, 18 knots. They have armor. Let's look at the armament. Four quick firing 8-inch 40 caliber guns with 352 HE shells and 220 armor penetrating shells. We have secondary armament, 16 quick firing 6-inch 40 caliber guns with 1100 HE shells and 967 armor piercing shells. No torpedoes, I believe. Oh, yes. I don't see them on the model. Plus ammo per turns. I'm not sure what that means. Seaworthiness. And requires 85 supply. I think this is a new concept to previous versions of, or previous versions of ironclads. So we have three of those, and then we have these torpedo boats. First class torpedo boat number 209, 120 tons, maximum speed of 18 knots as well. No armor, of course. They have two quick firing 3-pounder 1.8 inch guns. I believe those were Hotchkiss, and they have high explosive shells. And then we have two 15-inch Whitehead torpedo tubes with a total of four torpedoes, I believe. Okay. So we have four of these torpedo boats, three commerce raiders. I'm not sure if they were actually called or classed as commerce raiders and not rather light cruisers or armored cruisers or something of that sort. I think commerce raiders was something that only appeared in later times historically. Where else do we have assets? We have some land units here. Let's go first for the ships. Armed transports, we have two armed transports, 960 ton of displacement. They have 1.85 inch of armor, two quick firing 12 pounder 3-inch guns, 320 shells, and four quick firing 6-pounder guns, 2.2 inch, with 1080 high explosive shells. Doesn't seem to have torpedoes. And then we have these transports, 650 tons slower, one quick firing 12 pounder 3-inch gun, and two quick firing 3-pounder 1.8 inch guns. That's definitely not an overpowered ship. So two armed transports and some army transports, and then I believe that's the same here. So that will mean eight of each so far, and then we have some, I believe those are destroyers, torpedo boat destroyers, 410 tons, no armor, one quick firing 12 pounder 3 inch gun, five quick firing 3 pounder 1.8 inch guns, and two 15 inch Whitehead torpedo tubes. And then these are supply ships. They create supply now. This used to be the money. I kind of like this change. So these generate 370 supply per turn. And this might well be it for the naval assets, unless, yes, I think we have some more units here. Masted belted cruiser Knyaz Pozharsky and third class torpedo boat number 6. Okay, it's torpedo boats, we already know. It's one only anyway. But we have these three masted cruisers here. And quick firing 6-inch 40 caliber guns and 8 quick firing 12 pounder 3-inch guns. As always, very beautiful models. And then we have an additional supply ship here. And oh, this is an additional torpedo boat that we can move, actually. Okay, now let's check. Well, first of all, let's see here. This is new. So we can install a submarine base. They have a 1 to 25% chance to destroy blockaders per turn. The bigger the offending ship, the bigger the chance to sink it. Okay, fair enough. We could order an additional supply ship. Click to order, takes 4 turns and generates additional income. We could build a fortification. And improves the combat strength of our units by 50%. And then there are the coastal batteries and the minefields. Those were already present in previous franchises. What is it for land units that we have here? This is a militia. And over here is where the meat's at. So some regular infantry, I believe. No, those are even, they are amphibious. Amphibious, what about these? No, that's regular infantry, more or less, as far as I know. It's called militia, though. What about here? These are amphibious. I believe there are only two categories of land units. I don't see slots for siege artillery either, unlike in previous franchises. Maybe that is because siege artillery wasn't historically used in this war. Okay. I believe there is one additional ship here. An auxiliary cruiser. Five-inch 40 caliber, 2 times, and 6-pounders, 2.2-inch, 4 times. Okay. So I believe we can't order any. Oh, and there is one more here. Okay, so we have quite a number of ships. There is one here as well. But I don't think we can order. Huh. I don't think we can. I don't think we can order new ships, can we? We can send land units to the hospital. But I don't think we can repair ships, obviously, but we can't order new ships. So a priority has to be, except for supply ships, I suppose. I think priority has to be to safeguard our force. We have some additional torpedo boats here. And that's pretty much it. Can we even, what about land units? I don't think we can train additional land units either. That's going to make it hard, I think. How to proceed? Let's take a look at the enemy. I think we should nope, we can't build. I think we should invest. In securing our ports. How much are these fortifications? 750 supplied. Right now we have 2,850. We could add a supply ship over here. And I think that's it for the supply ships. There is one additional slot. I think we should do that, and we should do it at the beginning of the game to profit the most from the additional income. So let's do that. But it's already 1,000 supply gone. And we'll save the rest because I'm pretty sure we're going to need it to be able to repair our ships. Now we have to think about how to counter the Japanese. Should we do anything offensively? We are currently blockading some of the overseas trade of Japan. 2% and 2%. Koshima is completely open at the moment. Can I move troops over?
Yeah, sir.
I can. Should we try to snatch a port from them? Can't move the non-amphibian units. Let's see if we can take it from them. I'm not going to move the naval assets for now. I just want to see what happens. In case they try to... Because like this, I have a nice force in pretty much all the ports that I can work with. And we'll just see what happens. Let's end the turn and see how things go down. Let's do a manual battle. So we are with a auxiliary cruiser, the Usuri, 3,450 tons, the top speed of 14 knots, no armor, 2 quick firing 5 inch 40 caliber guns and 4 quick firing 6 pounder 2.2 inch guns, a total of 1,700 shells. We only have 25% experience. And What is it that we're facing? Sea state, that's new. The sea state is moderate. 0.9 meters of wave height. So that's quite some heavy firepower that we're facing. Although one individual ship isn't that much larger, but they are armored, they're heavier, they are faster, and they have more gunpowder. So we have to keep a distance. And they are bringing two of these cruisers and then two gunboats that we would have a better chance of matching. We're completely outnumbered, outgunned, and potentially even outrun, so we'll have to make sure. Do we have torpedoes? Yes, so this ship does it have torpedoes? It looks like it does, but according to this interface, but it doesn't look like it on the stats. But some of these ships had underwater torpedo tubes. But I don't think it has torpedoes according to the stats. So for us, the important thing here is to keep our distance and try to avoid taking any damage. Okay, now we have this indicator here, so this is if we get this close and there is a low chance of getting hit and outside, we should be safe. What happened? So this first battle, I will try to just outrun them because I'm outmatched completely. That's why I'm going fast. There's really no point in trying to seek the engagement. Try if we can get a better look at the enemy. They actually have pretty good reach. They're 6-inch guns. I think this can get hairy, given how much faster they are. I don't know if the game yet models something like rain squalls or fog. It would allow to hide or run somehow. How far is it to the border? Not that far. We have still 1.25 to go. Of battle time. Enemy is speeding up, of course. Let's make sure we don't run out of space. Suri is steaming away at full speed. To be honest, these look terrifying. They are going at 15 knots. And I think they are dropping the gunboats. still falling behind. Yep, can't quite keep up. You have to be completely tone deaf or aesthetical if you don't admire the beauty of these ships and indeed the models. I'm one of the officers on the bridge. Some crew training the guns. I might have heard when first shot. Oh, they're automatically firing. Okay, so the rear gun is firing at the enemy. I think we'll stop firing. The accuracy has to be very low. Of course, this is time compressed, so movement would rather look like this, maybe. But since we're just running down the clock, going with the accelerated time, let's go and see if the Japanese already tried to open fire on us. They're maneuvering. I think they want to cut us off. We're still at a distance of 30 something cable, which means they caught up by 20 cables. We are nearing the border. A corner. I'm turning starboard. Not sure we can outrun them. And probably a bad idea to turn this way. They'll be able to cut us off. Let's see if we can. Yeah, we'll have to try to break through. Turning again is a bad idea. Luckily, only 59 minutes left. let's target this. They already did take some damage. Do we take any damage? Okay, so the AI did a pretty good job. He actually did hit. It's pretty impressive. 29 cables. Closing slowly. I have to stop the game because I'm trying to aim. This distance 29.7 cable. The maximum gun range pretty much for us. Select. It's gone. Soon be into their 1% range. According to this indicator. So that was way too far ahead. The enemy. I don't see the splashes. I think the forward gun is pretty good. We're now at a distance of 28.5 cable. Oh, we hit him. I just saw the damage indicator go up from 0 to 5.1%. And another hit on the port side. We should adjust the range. Just want to double check the distances. 28 cable. This is very hard to do in how the ship is moving some in a fast game. Yeah. Now we'll keep hitting them on the starboard side. There's also a way to see whether the guns are ready. Somehow, I think the mouse... Yeah, now they are ready. How about the rear gun? The rear gun as well. So we've inflicted a combined 20% damage. Yep, we're closer now, so we'll readjust the distance. Those were misses. It's kind of hard to tell how to adjust shots, I think. Adjust the angles like this. So the rear gun is too far forward. Those look pretty good. Yes, another hit. and the hit on the starboard side. We combined 30% out of 200%, and so far we haven't taken any damage. Problem is, we are nearing the border. So here's what I'm gonna do. We're just going to turn away. And run the other way. And if we can inflict damage on one of their cruisers without taking any damage in return, we're already doing a great job against two cruisers and two gunboats in just a tiny auxiliary cruiser. I'm very proud of this ship and its crew. They're doing a great job. And we can already turn the guns to the other side. Actually turn quite fast. I don't think there is much point in firing while we're turning. I think those shots are pretty much bound to miss. Now let's speed things up during the turn. Actually, I think increasing the distance. Yeah, a little bit. Because they aren't turning as fast as we are. Took a while to react. That's not me firing, that must be them firing. I've turned off my guns. Are they firing? I don't know. They are still faster than me. I don't know why they pick their time to close in. Maybe they don't like the fact that they were taking damage. They were firing. We didn't take any hits so far, so let's train the guns. But they are kind of getting close. I think we have some. Not much, but we have some sea space. Work with. Let's see if we can inflict some more damage. What's the distance? 25.86 cable. Okay, the forward gun way too far back. Suggest that. Still too far back. So we adjust the distance. 25. And 5. The distance is about right. Forward gun is now too far forward. Now we took some hits on the port side, and both our guns are too far back. Ouch. They hit quite hard. Unfortunately, the damage decals also appear on the other side, on the starboard side, even if the indicator says he took damage only on the port side. The problem is now that we'll soon have to face quite a number of guns. And for some reason, we aren't inflicting any damage anymore. Let's see if the AI can do a better job than I can. Now we'll try to dodge a little bit. My steering. We'll slow down and then maybe try a turn. No hit, but they hit us in again for another 10% on the port side. And again, that's pretty costly. Let's see if we can switch fire to this gunboat. I think it's actually closer. It should take more damage. Now we'll try to turn the ship around. See if we can make it through the next 37 minutes. Because it's a smaller target, the AI isn't actually firing at it. So I switch target to the rear cruiser. See if we can get a hit in on this one. Problem is, we are definitely cornered. Ouch! They've set us on fire. Let's put the crew on damage control. One more minutes. It's going to be tough. And the enemy is closing. but I think the crew is taking care of them. The fire damage is going up, but the regular damage is going down, I believe. Yeah. Yeah, but we keep taking more damage. Turn the other way, but they keep hitting us for 10% of damage a hit, and the fire is increasing, fire is gaining. At least they keep missing for the last couple of salvos. But there are a lot of guns firing at us now. Ouch. And we're also taking on water. Probably a hit to the water line. Twenty-eight more minutes. I don't think we can make it. Might lose the Suri. Oh, heavy damage on the starboard side. Two percent on the starboard side, 12% flooded, and the fire that's gaining. Well then, what can I do? Can I click these elements? Did they do anything? I don't think I can. I don't know if those are the places where I took damage or what exactly that is. This is probably the flooding damage. I think the flooding is the most severe problem at the moment. I don't see how we're gonna make it for 28 minutes. I was of the opinion that we could cleverly outrun the enemy, but that clearly doesn't work. Not against four enemies and not with this speed difference. That's just too much. Pretty close, 11 cable. Those are going to hurt. Devastating hit. It is up by 20%. They're going to be more accurate as well, of course. Loading increases, fire is gaining. 20 more minutes. I'm just going to try to dodge a little more. It's looking pretty bleak. Secondary armaments now opening up on us. We're going to be lucky if this ship makes it out of the battle. 17 minutes. Okay. I was able to retreat. Oh, that's nice. Okay, let's see this land battle. Okay, so that's for this turn. Well, this was a first impression of Sakhalin, Clad in Iron, 1904 in Sakhalin. I'm very pleased with this newest addition to the Ironclad series, and we'll continue next time. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you.